Good afternoon, everyone. First of all, it's really important that I say a couple of words. This is the first forum which I'm speaking at, which is officially related to IIT Kharagpur, and I'm really indebted to that particular place. What I am today, what BlackBuck is gearing up to be, I think, really fortunate to have got through that particular school. With that note, I will split my 5 minutes into 3 minutes of how did essentially my journey of starting up was, and probably 2 minutes on, when you typically scale, what challenges you face, and if you could just, some pointers on that. So before just going into that, how many people in this room are actually thinking of starting or have already started up with a, count of hands? Thinking also is fine. Okay, great. So that's close to, I think, 40%. So I'll probably try to, most of the pointers would be more targeted towards that particular audience. So guys, I think starting up and calling off that particular shot is the first pivotal moment in terms of going ahead and doing something like this. So with me, the story was really, it isn't a very cool story, because it was not like I was in the Paris night and I didn't get a cab and I started off a cab company. The story was bit more very contextual. I was an ops guy back in college as well, was reading subjects in operations, wanted to do something with respect to operations and supply chain, got a job with ITC at KGP placements, got into it, really fell at the right place at the right time where I was given this particular opportunity to really revamp the supply chain of the back, of the business in ITC, which was leaf tobacco business. And across that, that's where essentially I picked up all the concepts of supply chain, of operations, everything. And when I was heading the supply chain for leaf tobacco after 3 years, by that time we had cut about 25% of the costs at ITC for them. So. So all the concepts which were there, which we applied within the business, essentially today are BlackBuck's fundamental business model. We're trying to do that for the economy, be it reverse haul exchanges, be it direct procurement models, be it technology, be it dashboard analytics, everything. All of that is something which is coming together. So for me, starting up was more being in the industry, knowing through what challenges exist as a freight buyer, coming out, solving those challenges for freight buyers and for the suppliers. That's the business model for BlackBuck. So a brief one-liner into what we do. We are intercity marketplace for trucking. Any shipper who needs to ferry goods from one city to another city using full truck loads as the mode of operations, we serve them. So we today serve about 250 clients all across the country, 300 locations. We are operative right from Jammu to Tuticorin and the entire Gandhinagar to Guwahati. We are operational all across. We serve all the large clients in the country, Unilever, Pepsi, Coke, Marico. One very fascinating thing which happened for BlackBuck was that we scaled to 1,000 people organization, a 300 locations operations organization with 250 clients in a period of close to about 12 months from the beginnings. That was something which was fabulous for us. The team which we had built kept on going and kept on guzzling, and providing bandwidths to keep scaling. So coming back to starting up, I think it's important that you're committed to what you're doing, and you really are clear in terms of whether you want to sign up for that kind of journey or not, right? Sometimes there are many entrepreneurs whom I meet who believe that while they are working, they would continue to, implement, operate, build a company. I think, that's my take. I think it would definitely differ in certain small proportion of the cases. But I think you really have to, be clear about whether you want to do this or not. And then that clarity would typically comes with your association to that particular problem and your understanding of that particular problem, right? So a full-time effort into starting up is really easy, right? Then when you are actually trying to take that particular step, it's important that how will cash flows be managed because you are essentially calling quits, right? So what I did there was I essentially got married. And my wife was my classmate from Kharagpur, and she decided that she'll feed me for a couple of years. So we signed up for a 2 to 3 year plan that without cash flows as a company, on the income of one, we will survive. And that was not much of an issue. Definitely cut down in lifestyle. All of that is something which we have to be prepared with. And then post that, essentially started doing lot of pilots, started running, you know, even it'd be a single order, trying to execute that, learning the market, launching your MVP fast. I think what the earlier speaker, Swati, had said, it's really important that you really are not hooked on to what you have thought when you started up, right? It's important to go ahead in the market, roll out your offering, what you think about, try, and then, you know, try to get it working. That's really important. What you think today, execute tomorrow in the startup phase. And so essentially what you end up doing is failing fast and getting down to the right solution, because mostly solutions are iterative. In the case where you really know the product market fit, you probably would be able to design some solution, which was in our case. But then in some of the solutions, it's really important you keep executing. Now, moving forward, what was really important with respect to the the recent successes, I would really not use the word success because there's a long journey to go for BlackBuck, is the team behind it. So what's important definitely is the founding team, right? You really got to choose your founders with whom you're going to really build this company. And choosing a founder, what I would say is actually like, it's another marriage, because that is a person whom with you'll be sharing so many thoughts with. That's a person with whom you'll be essentially spending more time than your wife. So it's really important that you choose people whom you've known before, whom you've worked with before, because co-working is very different than knowing friends, right? And that's something which you would understand when you typically face scenarios. So choosing your founding team, then moving forward, the first 50 people of BlackBuck, what we built was through networks, right? So all the key in charge of operations and, let's say, key in charge of engineering, products, etc., were the people whom at least, let's say, either the founders or, because the networks really work there, because you've seen those people grow, transform into different professionals over a period of time. So the first set of 50 people was important to get the thinking right and ensure that what you wanted to drive with the kind of aggression, with the kind of perspective gets driven. And one important thing in that 50 was that apart from three of us, the entire 1,000-member company does not have anyone from logistics. That's the complete change in mindset which we wanted to bring in when we were building solutions. So that really worked well for us. Initially, it's a cost trade-off between when the guy comes on board, is he going to become, will he be productive from day 5 versus day 30? I think we chose day 30. Let him learn logistics after having being on board BlackBuck. That's more important than hiring for experience in the initial days, right? So that's sort of starting up experience. Then the company raised a couple of funds. We were there. We were sort of out there to scale. And while we scaled, it's really important to look at what you're essentially trying to get to, right? So if you're a very highly product-based company, if you're a company building scaling on technology, it's really important to keep that mission in between. When you essentially deviate from that, you end up creating, you started creating a technology product company, you end up creating an operations company. And for us, in a couple of processes, that definitely happened, right? The core team which was formed was more business-led, and hence scaling happened more on operations-driven strategies, more on selling-driven strategies, but not the core product strategy. That's something which the company had to unlearn, over a period. So we scaled from, let's say we were at a scale of zero in the month of July last year when we started. We went to a scale of 2 in December. From 2 to we went to a scale of 20. Through the operations route, right? That was really important to unlearn from that 20 back to 2. We definitely did not lose revenues, but we had to really course correct all those particular processes. Then again from March, we scaled to 100 with the right processes. So it's really important to keep that core of what your business model is, how would you want to execute, and moving forward, right? So so that's something which is useful to keep in mind while we are scaling a company. And a couple of other things is probably which I would like to share here is, the journey is always gruelsome. I think entrepreneurship, it teaches people a lot. It brings out the best in individuals. And we all really have to sustain that particular journey, be open towards it, because the last 1.5 years post starting up have been hell of a ride for me. and for my team. I think with that, I would love to hear out some questions from the audience. So my founding partners, one founding partner is, it's a very diverse team. One founding partner is my junior from college, IIT Kharagpur, 3 years junior to me. I was his first boss, and first boss ever, and he was my first member of the team ever. So it was my first year at ITC. He was interning in my team, and he was solving a big piece of warehousing project for me. He interned, he was successful, we offered him employment, joined my team. When I was heading the supply chain, he was heading planning. So that's how we understand. And back at ITC also, he was the guy to whom I used to draw it on a whiteboard and leave the rest to him. And he was the guy for me for everything, right? So that was something which, again, exists back at BlackBuck. And that helps me be out of the mundane routine operations, execution, and most of the work. The other founder has 17 years of experience from a company called Mibak Consulting. He was the managing director of the entire Asia Pacific. So how I met him, when at first year of ITC, when I was solving this problem, we across the 5 years of experience at ITC, we have engaged close to 4 consulting firms for helping us solve problems. 3 projects were engaged. We engaged Mibak, and he was leading the task on the other side, and I was leading the task on this side. We became really good friends. And so I knew how he executed, what he did, what he brought onto the table. And we 3 founded together and built the company. And one thing which is, you know, to people who sort of start up, it's important that, you know, so given such a diverse background, right, it's always tricky to solve for that, you know, how do we really come together, what we do. So we 3 are equal partners, and that's what we believe in. And that's what we believe as a philosophy, not only for the team, but as well as the entire extended team. So those practices reflect our internal processes, openness, which we bring onto the table.
In the interest of time, we can allow just one more question, if there is any. Any questions?
BlackBuck.com.
Thank you, Rajesh. I know running a logistics business is very, very complicated. Thank you. Bye. So for the next session, I want to invite Mr. Tambe. Mr. Mohan Tambe?